हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर नम्रता खिलोचिया, राफेल बीबीए कॉलेज, वापी, इन द सब्जेक्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, SYBBA, थर्ड सेमेस्टर। वी आर मूविंग विद द यूनिट नंबर 2, दैट इज जॉब एनालिसिस। वी हैड डिस्कस सो मैनी मेथड्स ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन अंडर जॉब एनालिसिस। इन टूडेज सेशन we will be going to move further with one of the popular method of job analysis, that is FJA. FJA stands for functional job analysis. The question may ask in a form of short note for 7 marks. So let's try to understand about this method. FJA method was developed by Sydney A. during the 1950s as a part of the Functional Occupational Classification Project. FJA's main feature, that is, yes, it is employees oriented, where the detailed description regarding the employee is given. Functional job analysis is a qualitative method of gathering specific data regarding job information. This produces unique information based on the employee's behavior and action, and that information is further used to write job description. So let's talk about functional job analysis gathered which kind of information. So here FJA collect the information which is available in 7 major ways. These are, first one, things. Here use of the machine and tools need to be described. Second, data. Workers' involvement with information and ideas need to be listed down here. Third one, worker instruction and amount of the autonomy in the task. So how much the autonomy given to the employees with the responsibility need to be specified over here. Fourth one, reasoning. Here one need to list down the use of concepts and decision making. Fifth one, people. It includes the channel of communication and interaction take place between different level of employees. Sixth one, mathematics. And seventh one, that is languages, which include all the 3 aspects of language, that is reading skills, writing skills and speaking skills. FJA helps in 4 major areas. So let's discuss this 4 major areas. First one, identifying job task, responsibilities and qualification, job description and job specification. Setting performance standards. Yes, it also used in identification of the material for the training to workers for improving their skills and knowledge. And FJA also helps in identifying paths for internal mobility, which is also available in 3 parts or types, that is promotion, transfer and demotion, by providing various data in 7 major areas. FJA is worker oriented, as I told you earlier. Job analysis approach here is that to attempt and describe the whole person on the job. It tries to examine the fundamental components of data, people and things. So let's move further with the steps need to be followed under FJA method. There are 5 steps need to be taken under FJA method. These are, first one, the first involves the identification of the organization's goals for the FJA analysis. This analysis describes what should be as well as what is. Second, here the second step is the identification and description of various tasks, wherein tasks are defined as actions. The task actions may be physical, that is operating a computer, mental, for example analyzing the data, or interpersonal, for example consulting another person. The task statements developed in FJA must conform to a specific written format. The third step here with the analysis, that is analyzing the task. Each task is analyzed using 7 scales. These include 3 worker functions scales of reasoning, mathematics and language, as we had already discussed in the 7 content part of FJA. The fourth one step include the analyst develop performance standards to assess the result of the employee's task. And fifth one, the last step, deals with the development of training content required by the job holder. So these are the major 5 steps need to be proceed under FJA method. FJA is frequently used for government jobs. It provides a quantitative score of each job as a function of its complexity in relationship with people, data, and things. The results are helpful in fixing wage rates and in developing the employee succession plans. On the negative side, FJA takes a lot of time for collecting this kind of information. Training in its use may mean considerable investment of money. FJA consider 3 major methods under it, that is observation, interview and logbook. Experts agree that the choice of job analysis method depend upon the purpose to be served by the data. There is no one best way to conduct a job analysis. Whenever possible, multiple methods of job analysis must be followed. So, these are different methods of job analysis. Especially, we had discussed in today's session the method, that is FJA, functional job analysis, which is mainly focused on employees' performance. Thank you, students.